I can't wait to show you how to design these really cute cottage core themed mini sticker sheets in Silhouette Studio. So to make these stickers, you will need clip art. It could be clip art that you have designed or some images that you can use for your stickers. I'll be using this cottage core themed clip art that my husband Miles designed for our Secret Sticker Society members. You will also need Silhouette Studio, the free version is fine, a color printer, white matte sticker paper, and a cutting machine or scissors or a craft knife. Now, because we are creating stickers with this backing sheet, a cutting machine is going to be the best option because then you'll be able to kiss cut each of the stickers out and die cut all the way through the outline of the sheet. But if you do not have a cutting machine and you're using scissors or a craft knife, I would recommend making these individual stickers, but not putting this backing sheet on here. That will just make your life a lot easier. Okay, let's get started. So the first thing I'm going to do is upload my digital art and then create my individual stickers. After that, we're going to move on to creating the sticker sheets and then we'll put it all together. So you must know where you've got your clip art saved on your computer or laptop. And to open it up in Silhouette Studio, we're going to go to File and then Open. You'll find where you've saved it. And now I can select all of the different clip art designs that I want. So you could select all of them and then choose OK. And it will open each of them up on an individual tab in Silhouette. And they will look just like this. So I've already opened some of them up here. And what I will do is click on each of them and then just copy and paste them. So copy and then paste into a new project. I'll do the same for each of them. Okay, I've got 5 of my different clip art designs here. I'm going to select all of them. And first of all, can you see there's a red cut line being put automatically around the outside edge of each of them? I don't want that to be there because I am going to add a white offset to them, a bit of a buffer. So I'll open up the line style panel and on the second tab, I'll just make that line transparent and now you can see it's disappeared. And while they're all still selected so I can see what I'm doing, I'm just going to grab the top corner here and reduce the size of them all. That's better. And now let's move them around onto my project here so I can see each one. Now I want to make sure that my stickers are nice and small because they are going on a mini sheet. So they need to be usable, not too small, but at the same time, not so big that you can only fit a couple on the sheet, or what's the point of that? So I'm going to start reducing the size of them. Now, of course, if you want to put an exact size on, you can. You can just change the size, the width and the height here. But I am going to eyeball these and make sure that they're about the size I'm looking for. And then, because they're going a bit smaller, I'll probably zoom in and show you how I add the offsets. So one left here. So it's now time to add that offset around the outside. And an offset is a bit of a buffer where I can add a white border. And we can do that in a really quick and easy way and a nice uniform way too in Silhouette Studio. I think I'll make this one just a bit smaller. Great. Now let's select all of them. I'm going to open the offset panel, click offset, and I am going to go with the size that's come up here. It's the last setting I used, 0.05 inches. You can make your offset distance as big or as small as you like, and it might be dependent on how big or small your actual sticker design is. Let's choose apply. Now, while all of those red cut lines are still selected, I'm going to make the sticker inside white. So I'm going to go to the fill panel and make the fill white. It doesn't look like anything at all has happened, but if I select everything here and just bring them over, can you see there's now a white border around each of them? But look, on this one with the mushrooms, I need to make some changes because I actually don't want to have those little holes cut out. You might not mind, but I prefer to have a complete solid sticker backing. So I'm going to click on the red cut line only of this sticker. So make sure it's the red cut line and not the actual clip art design. I'm now going to right click on it and choose release compound path. Can you see it's separated it into 3 parts? Now I can click on each of these holes and delete them. And that one. And now when I move it over here, you can see it's a complete sticker. Okay, now to finish these individual stickers, I'll select each of them in turn, but both elements, the offset and the clip art, and do right click and group or control and G on your keyboard. So group, control G, control G, control G. And you would follow that exact process for all of your different clip art designs until you have all of them ready and then you can start to create the sticker sheet that you'll be putting them on and arranging them.
Okay, I've got more stickers that I've created here, and I've got my mini sheet. And before I start to arrange the stickers on top, I'll just walk you through how I put this mini sheet together. I began with a rectangle for the outside sheet. So I'm going to go over here to drawing tools and then click to draw a rectangle. You can do one with a rounded corner as I did, or you can do a straight corner here, more pointed corners. In fact, let's do that for this one. And I'll begin to draw my sticker sheet here. If you want to put an exact size in, you can. Now, next up, I decided to add a pattern to the background of this one. Now, you could do a white background. It doesn't have to be a color or a pattern. But to add a pattern, I went over here on the right-hand side to open the fill panel, and then I clicked on the third tab and chose the pattern I wanted. Now, I have patterns that match this range, and I'm going to click and choose one of these ones. I think I will go with the pink one there. I'm going to scale it down to 50%, so that makes the pattern feature more, and this is a seamless pattern. So what it's done is kind of zoomed out so that we can see more of the pattern, but it continues because it's completely seamless and repeating. Now, the next thing that I did was change the transparency, I think to 75%. I wanted to keep the color and the pattern, but when I position my stickers on top of here, I want you to really be able to see them and to see that white border around them. If you want to, you can add this section at the bottom, just like I have done here, where I've got the darker color and then I've got my name and logo on there. Now, this is the really fun part. It's a bit like a puzzle, and we want to make sure that we're featuring as many stickers as we can and we're not wasting space on the mini sticker sheet. But at the same time, we don't want the stickers too close together or like this. Our silhouette is going to have a really hard time cutting it out. In fact, it's going to cut through different stickers here, and we don't want to have pieces chopped off. So we can start to move these in place. And I'm going to start with the bigger stickers first of all. Not too close to the edge of the sheet. And that one looks good there. And let's pop you here. Maybe that one. Let's see. Maybe I'll rotate this one. If I click on it and a green dot appears, I can then rotate that sticker. Now, if you've got some leftover space, and I have got a gap here, what I'm going to do is just duplicate this one. So Control and D to duplicate. Let's change the rotation again so it fits better. And I think it gives the sheet a bit more interest when you've got different rotations of the same sticker. Now let's eyeball this and see. Yep, these ones are too close together. So I'm going to do a little bit of repositioning. But that one looks really good. In fact, I'm really happy with how that one's looking. And it's really as simple as that when you're putting that sheet together. So the next thing I would do is duplicate the whole of this sheet. So I can select all of it, right click and duplicate. And move this one over here. Then I can add a different pattern to the back of this one and a different color here. And you can keep all the sticker designs exactly as they are. You can change the rotation and the order of them, or you can create a completely different sheet altogether. It's the super fun part now. It's time to print and cut these stickers out. Okay, I already have my registration marks turned on, so we can go now to File and Print. I'll be printing on my Canon PIXMA, and I'm going to go to More Settings, and then change the print quality to high, and then choose OK, and now print. Here's my sticker sheet all printed, and I've got my silhouette mat here. So I'll be positioning this sheet onto the mat, lining it up and smoothing this down. And now this is ready to feed into my silhouette portrait cutting machine. Let's click send. And on the second tab, the line tab, I'm going to select the red cut line and deselect anything else here. And let's check here in the panel. I only want these red lined stickers to be kiss cut out and nothing else. So that looks good. Now I'm going to go with my sticker paper settings that I usually use. Of course, depending on the machine, the blade age, the mat you have, the sticker paper thickness, and your preferences, you might choose a different setting. But I'll pop mine in now. So I'm going to change the force and the speed and the blade depth, and then I'm going to hit send to cut these out. Now, if you are really comfortable with your cutting, you might want to select the gray line to cut at the same time, but I'm going to do it step by step so I can walk you through each stage. Now it's time to cut out the outside edge of our mini sticker sheets. So I'll deselect the red kiss cut line and now select the gray line that I chose. to cut around these edges. And I'm going to now change my settings here so that this will cut straight through. Now, you might choose to have a deeper cut so it cuts through the edge of this sheet in one go. Or if you prefer, you might want to have multiple passes here so that it will cut straight through, but in maybe 2, 3, 4 different passes, whatever works for your the thickness of your sticker paper so that it doesn't have jagged edges. It's a bit of trial and error here, so you will have to come up with the settings that suit your paper and your machine. Oh, stop it. How cute are these? I think they've turned out brilliantly. I'm so happy with how they're looking. Oh, and I really, really like the little pop of color on the background of these stickers, but aren't they sweet? Okay, let's do a bit of a peel test on these. So I want to be able to peel off my Kiss Cut stickers without affecting the sheet behind, and that's working perfectly. So here is my sticker. Look at that lovely clean cut line. And I'm really happy with how these turned out. I hope you loved making these super cute stickers. I really enjoyed showing you how. And if you've got more sticker making questions or you want to dive in more on your own sticker making journey, I'm here to help. I've put together a free sticker making guide just for you. So you can go to the link on the screen right now or mimjenkinson.com/YT guide. So mimjenkinson.com/YT guide. You'll be able to access my sticker making guide right now for free. Can't wait to see the stickers that you make, so make sure you share them with me. I would love to know if this class has inspired you to get started too. Thank you so much for watching.